Hi everyone, welcome to Vaishi Makeup, and I'm going to show you how to blow dry your hair if you are a beginner like me. And I'm also going to show you a quick half up and half down hairstyle if you're a busy mom or a lady or a professional. So to begin with, I have shampooed and conditioned my hair and applied serum, and now I'm going to take a white comb and just detangle my hair. Just be nice to your hair, and with a very light hand, I'm going to just remove all the knots. Now let's come to hair drying, and I'm using Vega Iconic Style 1700 watt hair dryer. It has ionic and fragrance powerful airflow, which retains moisture and reduces frizz. It has two heat, two speed setting for the perfect styling. It is of 1700 watt for professional styling level, and it has safety automatic overheat cutoff. So the first step of blow drying is sing a song and feel amazing about yourself and about your day. And now remove the hair dryer nozzle first, and then dry your hair while running fingertips through them. And your hair should be like 70% dry, so it takes around like 4 to 5 minutes to dry them all. So now I'm going to use my Vega tail comb. I like this comb because it has smooth rounded teeth which do not hurt my scalp. So I always believe in investing in a good comb. So now I'm going to divide my hair into two sections here. Basically, I am creating a center parting and then making them into a fourth part. To clip up my section, I'm using this Vega hair clips, or you can say sectioning clip, which are non-slip design hair clips which hold more hair securely. It's very good for those who have thick hair like me. Now I'm using this hot curl hairbrush from Vega, which I really like and recommend. This hairbrush is ideal for curling during blow drying. It has heat activated ceramic coating which cuts drying out time, and hair setting lasts really long. It's time to reattach the nozzle back onto the dryer and bring out the brush. All you have to do is wrap the root around the brush and point your nozzle at it and keep brushing outward until they are dry. So it might look a little difficult in the beginning because you're using both of your hands, but with time you can do it and you can get it. Although I still find it a little difficult, but with little practice it's not difficult, especially with this hairbrush which is very lightweight, and the hair dryer is also pretty lightweight, so I still somehow manage it. Do this section by section, and while drying and brushing, pulling your hair away from scalp helps in giving it that great volume. Also, for the front hair, just lift the section from the crown and point the nozzle at it, and this will give them more volume. So don't forget to do that with your front hair. So you are doing three things. You are giving volume to your hair, you are removing the frizz, and of course you're blow drying as well. So keep working from back to front, and here I am with my blow dried hair. Now let's come to the quick half up and half down hairstyle. I generally make this hairstyle on the second day. It makes my hair look neat and gives me more control to my hair. So for this, you have to make a half ponytail, and I'm using my tail comb for it. It generally helps, and I don't even need a mirror to check out how it's coming out because it generally comes out neat. So just take your crown hair and make a ponytail and wrap a rubber band, whatever rubber band is available with you, and just start making a regular braid with it. After I've made my braid, I'm going to just wrap it around and secure it with a bobby pin, and that's it. It's so simple, but people will ask you how you did it because it looks pretty difficult. Also, to give more volume to your front hair, just pull them out a bit. That's about it. My quick half up and half down hairstyle is ready, and I've showed you two things in one video. I hope you like it, and if you want me to do more video like this, then hit like and subscribe. Bye bye.